On November 5th, 2005, at the age of 19, Preston took to the field 3 weeks after being diagnosed with a concussion. He collided head-on with an opposing player on a punt return at Duquesne University. He was briefly knocked unconscious, awoke, was combative for a few minutes, and then lapsed into a coma.
I normally do not like to have hearings just for the sake of having hearings. And in all honesty, that was my intention when we first decided to have hearings on concussions. I thought we would have one or two bills. But the further I delved into this, the more I realized this is a topic that needs an awful lot of discussion. We are learning more and more about it every day. And the thing that's most distressing to me as I was doing the research is how often kids simply either don't recognize it or don't report it. They think, you know, it's macho. You hear about, you know, taking a big hit in the first half and got to be in there for the final play of the game without realizing the consequences that it can have on your entire life.
There is a national awareness right now about concussions. It began with the professional athletes, and we're now realizing that we need to look at what's happening to our young people.
We think it's such a rarity, but what we're hearing today is that a concussion is not a rarity, and the experience that these students are having are not rare, that they're happening much more commonly than we expected, and that there's possibility that there's an underreporting of these types of incidences.
I'm a 16-year-old student athlete whose life has been negatively impacted by a series of concussions. I have had not one, not two, but 11 concussions. We were led to believe that each concussion was a standalone incident. Sometime later, when it was too late to undo, we learned that concussions are cumulative.
I think any time that you have a student that suffers a student athlete that suffers a concussion, you always think about getting the athlete back on the field. But now we're hearing the academic side of it, where she had to be homeschooled for a number of months and just recently went back to school. I think that's the most surprising thing that's come out of the whole conversation we're having today.
Many of these young people are put right back into the sports that they're involved in without any interruption. It needs to be some real closer look at when these kids are injured, the kind of treatment that they need, and the fact that maybe in some cases they have to be removed from the activity permanently.
We need, just as we educate parents about getting shots for measles and whooping cough and things of that sort, we have to also educate them about concussions.
Up to this point, I think there should be something, legislation coming out of this committee to say to the coaches and to our high schools, our elementary schools, that we need to take a closer look. We need to pay attention, and we need to be focused on what is happening. And you need a medical profession to take a look at these children when they are involved in these sports. If they fall and they bang their head and they say they have a headache.